Mariner. The hull took a battering. Be sure. She wouldn't be standing at all if it weren't for you. They call me the Mariner. Shipwreck. Handyman. I'm the only one keeping the harbor afloat. Beside Captain Aaron.
Why doesn't anyone help you?
Each harborman is the captain of his own ship. Worked fine for generations on the homesteads. Your land, your rules. But when the island pushed them onto my dock, one by one, the ungrateful bastards expect me to look after my land, even though they're squatting on it, like wretches.
If it's that bad, why put up with it?
I couldn't very well toss them back into the fog, could I? Bad luck. Surely their spirits would haunt me to my grave. And that's a fact.
Town's lucky you're here.
You blowing smoke up my sails? There is... I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand. In order to do proper repairs, I need tools. Specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. 450 caps if you can, though.
So, I'd be risking my life for only 450 caps.
I'm a bit short on caps. But I have old Jimmy's shotgun, I can give you. Heavens no, he can't use it anymore.
You've kept the walls together this long. Why do you need special tools now?
I want to build the hull up proper. Make it strong. And keep those blasted crabs out.
Sign me up. I'll help.
Eagle's Cove Tannery. Tools are certain to be there. Get.
Avery. I wonder what the Mariner's real name is.
I'll be straight.
I bet it's Velma.
It's never easy to ask anyone on this island for help, much less a stranger. But I've got a responsibility to these people, and I have a job for you if you're up for it. Besides, I know you're tougher than you look.
What exactly do you need help with?
We get our drinking water from a purifier not far outside of town. We had a bad storm not long before you got here, and it must have damaged the fog condensers that protect the road to the purifier. I sent Howard Dunbar out to fix them. He was out there when the Mirelurks hit us. I'm afraid they might have got him, too. I was hoping you might go have a look. If the worst happened, maybe you could get those fog condensers back online. If you're up to it, just head south out of town. It's paying work, of course. I wouldn't ask a stranger to stick their neck out on our behalf, unless I was willing to pay a fair share for it.
Am I gonna need any tools or parts if I have to make these repairs on my own?
The fog condensers need their power modules replaced, but Howard took the only spares we have. Either way, you're gonna have to find him first.
What exactly are these fog condensers? How do they work?
Well, I'm no engineer, but the way it was explained to me, each fog condenser pulls in the air around it and then condenses it into liquid. The point being, the fog doesn't get past them. They make a barrier that protects the town. No fog means that all the nasty things living in it stay in it. They don't venture out too often. The fog's at home, I guess. The fog condensers eat up a lot of power, but we've got a wind farm that takes care of it. As long as the turbines stay charged, we stay safe.
All right. I'll head out there now.
Good. Our water supply won't last much longer.
Got it.
Didn't mind learning that trick myself.
Thank you.
Let's do it.
The fish that washed up on the beach in the Commonwealth were big. Have you noticed how big they are here?
Thank you.
truck full of good wine. I hope someone hangs.
Hey.
I can do that.
Hey. Hey.
What?
Who said I was a detective?
Mayor Avery said that someone new had arrived on the island, investigating a missing person. That must be you. I haven't been able to find any of the local police force. The louts. I don't want to start a panic, but, well, we may have a murder on our hands, and we need an outside set of eyes.
Where did the crime take place?
At the Cliff's Edge Hotel, just north of the town. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
Who's the victim?
Well, we want to keep this out of the tabloids, but it's Ezra Parker, the financier of the hotel. Please, you must help us. Every moment we wait, our residents are at risk.
Who are your employers?
I shouldn't say out here in the open, but my employers are quite wealthy, as are the other patrons of the hotel. Will you help us? There may still be a murderer at large.
Is this conversation on the clock?
Oh, yes. Well, I suppose I do have a bit of petty cash on me that I could provide for your time. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
This type of investigation usually requires a retainer.
Oh, you're a private investigator, not an employee of the state. Well, yes, then I suppose a retainer can be arranged. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
If there may be a murderer, I'm gonna need some danger pays.
I'm afraid that's all I have on me, but my employers are, well, rather wealthy, and I can definitely put a word in for you. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
I suppose I could take a look.
I'm afraid that any further negotiations will have to be with my employers, though I'm sure they would be more than fair with you. Please, you must help us. Every moment we wait, our residents are at risk.
Okay, I'll help.
Oh, thank goodness. Shall I guide you to the Cliff's Edge Hotel now?
Go ahead. I'll meet you there.
Very good. I shall meet you at the main entrance to the hotel.
Longfellow knows what he's about.
Grandpa George can rest in peace. The Fogcrawler is dead.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic adventurer I hoped you were. With that Fogcrawler gone, we can send some folks up there to get the place ready for you. That's right. The farm is yours. Your own little piece of the island. It'll take work to get it up and running again, but you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton lineage.
Surely a heroic avenger deserves more than 200 caps.
I can agree to that. Here's another 100 caps. Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong as any person can know. But if you ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people. That's why the last part of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
We were married. What happened?
My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget, I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse. No doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mall rats. Their leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You gotta get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
Wait, did you just call someone else crazy? That is priceless.
What? I don't get your meaning. Ugh, never mind. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun. trappers might look like us, but the island took their souls.